This reflector is a function of the rate of coordinate, can be expressed in the form of the Fourier transform, the quantity of K, which turns out to have a relatively straightforward form. It's the circle of energy gap, delta, which is a general complex quantity, but that's, in this context, that's rather trivial, so let's take it for the moment. And this should actually be the trivial one half, is missing in this question here. I'm sorry, that's okay, that's not possible. So basically, the question of K is rather straightforward. If K, in the reason this is not, if K is not zero, only in the range between these two cutoffs above and below the Fourier surface. Okay? Remember that we have you have this region around the surface where basically the reaction takes place. And if in the region level, the potential envelope is in that region, so if K is equal to zero in that region. Now it's convenient to define a quantity that is I prime h by the f over delta. That is not what is commonly defined in the literature. What is commonly defined is a simple pickup coherence length, for historical reasons basically, and that that is actually related to my z prime by factor pi. So that's also very trivial. The important point to notice is that z prime over is the order of EF over delta times K to 1 over the this definition here. Since the form velocity is simply EF over h bar over RK. So z prime is this order of magnitude. So relative to the inverse frame momentum, the derivative of a dense frame system, the inverse frame momentum is basically the distance between particles. So relative to that distance between particles, you have this branch factor, EF over delta, typically over 10 to the 3 to the 4. So z prime is very large compared to that, typically 10 to the 3 to 10 to the 4 angstroms in a typical old fashioned BCS supercomputer like a minimum. So now let's, for a moment, consider values of R, which are large compared to HWF over this quantity epsilon cutoff. Now this is large compared to the distance between particles, but it's still small compared to the z-prime here. So, this is a cutoff here. This should just be a reference to my book, so this is a critical point. In that region, we can extend the sum of the K, which is equivalent to an integral over energies, extended plus or minus infinity, and then we can actually evaluate this piece to you. And what you find is that the power wave function, as a function of relative coordinate, is given by, this cofactor, which is 3 times the density of particles times delta over here, so factor there. Times, now this factor here is essentially what you would get for the behavior of two free particles at relative energy, free energy. Okay. So basically, as long as you've got this factor to consider, which would be true, when you compare that this factor, if you can, when R is not to this, then it's our prime, okay? Then, basically, our power function simply looks like the wave function of two particles moving freely, but flowing over at the surface, setting less than equal to zero. However, the important point is that this is now modified by, this should be a rho, that's the topic, exponential minus over 2 times rho over our prime. So, so then your power wave function now falls off exponentially beyond that distance. So in other words, truly speaking, the pairs of the group of pairs are bound in relative, this particular relative coordinate, and the size of the group of pair is roughly this type up here. Okay, so far? Okay, this leads us up to a point which I think is useful when discussing it in this context. The total number of pairs is given by the double integral over the center of mass coordinate, which is trivial, and the integral over the relative coordinate. And if you just put it in the logical, it turns out that that number, the number relative,